The next one we have is the equals method, which is very similar to our string dot equals, the same one that belongs to it. So we go public boolean equals, and then we need the object to check. So all classes inherit this method from the object class. It returns true if this object is the same as the other. So we need to give it an object to receive, which we will do. So we can check it even just through here. So I have hello you, and I have it with two integers. I'm going to create another instance of hello you equal new hello. I'm going to make it equal to 4. So I'm going to change the system.println. I'm going to make you dot. It's going to check to see if equals you. I'm going to check to see if these two objects equals each other. So I did not even need to create an instance over here. And this is talking about override. So let's check it out. And the answer is false. They do not equal each other. If I change them to 3 and 5, I should get true, but I don't. I get a false because they're not the same object. But if I go u dot equals u, it returns true. So these are actually not the same object, which means they do not equal each other, even though their information is the same. It'd be like having twins. Twin 1 and twin 2 have lots of the same attributes, but the twin themselves are two different people. So you did not equal you, because even though they're the same information, it's not the same object, but you does equal you. And I intentionally did the two different types of yous. So if you're listening to this, please come back and actually look at the video.